Good morning, students. Once again, a very warm welcome to the English world of Aradhya. Myself, Rashmin sir, imparting knowledge of English to the students of 9 to 12 standard in English medium. Students, if you remember, in my previous video, we had already started a new grammar topic. The title was Interrogative into Assertive. Okay, in that we had discussed how to convert a sentence assertive into interrogative and interrogative into assertive. What was the basic rule? If the given assertive sentence is positive, its interrogative will be negative. And if the given assertive sentence is negative, its interrogative is positive. The same thing is applicable for the interrogative into assertive also and assertive into interrogative also. So we had seen only a few sentences, students, basic sentences, where it begins with the subject and just relating to different tenses. Now, today we will see a few different types of sentences and how they are converted into assertive or interrogative. Okay, let me remind you, last time we had seen a few sentences like he is a lawyer. So, isn't he a lawyer? That is the interrogative of that sentence. He eats fast food. Doesn't he eat fast food? Remember, I had told you whenever all these auxiliaries or helping verbs are given, so you are supposed to use them in interrogative or assertive, but when they are not given, okay, and I told you when they are not given in simple present tense and simple past tense. So in such cases, we are using do, does, and did. Okay, do when the original verb is there in the sentence, does when the verb is having s, es, or ies in the end, and did when the verb is given in the past form. Okay, students, today we will see some other sentences which are known as WH question. So how will you convert a WH question into assertive? Okay, again you see, students, WH questions also can be positive also, negative also. So here I'll begin with the who question. Okay, so who, suppose the who question is positive. So, when you convert it into assertive, you don't have to do anything. Just in place of who, you begin the sentence with nobody, no one, or none. Okay? Remaining sentence will be as it is. The tense will not change. Keep that thing in mind. Okay? For example, who will call his mother a witch? Now, here, students, the answer is quite known to everyone. Ki koi apni maa ko dayan nahi bolega. So, yahan same thing is just related over here in the interrogation form. Ki kaun apni maa ko dayan bolega? Koi nahi bolega. So, answer is quite common, but this question has more effect than the plain statement. Okay, so here in place of who, we are writing just nobody. You can write no one or none. Nobody will call his mother a witch. Okay, students, so here it has now turned into assertive. The given question was who question, so it was interrogative, and since it was a positive question, because no word showing negation is there, no, not, never, all these words are not there, so the question automatically becomes positive question. And when you convert it into assertive, here you use nobody. So the sentence is converted into assertive plus it becomes negative. Okay. So this is the thing. You can also say, who does not enjoy India-Pakistan match? Okay. Now this is, students, here you see, I have taken who negative question. So when who question is negative, what do? We begin the assertive with एवरीबडी या एवरी वन. ओके, नाउ दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ नेगेटिव सेंटेंस. हु डज नॉट एंजॉय इंडिया पाकिस्तान मैच. इट मीन्स आंसर इज क्वाइट क्लियर. ओके, कि एवरीवन एंजॉयज इंडिया पाकिस्तान मैच और एवरीबडी एंजॉयज इंडिया पाकिस्तान मैच. सो हियर ऑल्सो अगेन इन प्लेस ऑफ हु यू आर सपोज टू राइट ओनली एवरीबडी. सो हु क्वेश्चन पॉजिटिव देन नोबडी, हु क्वेश्चन नेगेटिव देन एवरीबडी. इज इट क्लियर? आई थिंक इट इज वेरी क्लियर. सो एवरीबडी एंजॉयज. नाउ हियर स्टूडेंट्स बी केयरफुल अ बिट, because whenever does is there, we are adding s, es or is in the end of the verb. So when you give the answer of such question, it would be like this. Okay, does not will be removed, but the verb will take s, es or is in the end. So everybody enjoys India Pakistan match. Okay, so that became your assertive. Now again, if we take some more example of both, for example positive sentence, who positive question. Okay, who attended his reception, who was attended his reception. Now from the sentence you can make out that it is a positive question. So here the answer will assertive will begin with. So purposely students, I am writing int, that is for interrogative, and assert for assertive sentence. So first of all, you are supposed to identify whether the given sentence is assertive or interrogative. Okay, and then accordingly you are supposed to go. So here this question, who attended his reception, is a positive question. So in that case, in place of who, I will put nobody. Nobody here attended, showing past tense. So that I will keep same. Nobody attended his reception. Okay students, so this way your one more example is ready. Still I can give many more examples. Students, here we will take some other tense. Who can put, who can put life into inanimate object so who can put life into an inanimate objects. Now students, you know the question is such, only God can do this, but the other beings, human beings, cannot do it. So answer is nobody can put life into inanimate object. Okay, so students, here you see again who question was positive, so I began with nobody. So this only you are supposed to keep in mind. When who question is positive, its assertive begins with nobody, no one, yeah, none, any one of them. And when who question is negative, its assertive begins with everybody, yeah, everyone. Okay, students, here you can take many more examples. For example, who cannot do this sum, means everybody can do this sum. Okay, so like those students, so many examples are there, you can just put them in mind. Only thing is, keep in mind that you don't change the tense. Don't try to change the tense of the given sentence. Suppose here it is given, who does not enjoy India-Pakistan match? And if you write, everybody enjoyed India-Pakistan match. Now question is in simple present tense. And if you answer it in simple past tense, then even though you have turned it into assertive, because of the changing of tense, it is wrong. So keep in mind that in whichever tense the sentence is given, its assertive also will be done in that tense only. This is normal rule for all the types of sentences, students. Okay, we don't have to change the tense. Now if who question is over, then we can move ahead for the what question. Okay, now who questions, student shows that the subject of the sentence is not given. So in what question, what happens? Object is not given. So at the place of object, what we will do? We will write nothing or everything. Okay? So here suppose, what question students is positive. So there, in place of object, we will write nothing when the what question is positive, and when what question students is negative, so there we will write everything. Okay, it is so easy. Only thing is, don't change the tense. Okay, I'll give you some examples so it will be easier for you to understand. Now look at the example. What did he give to his brother? One simple question. Okay, उसने अपने भाई को क्या दिया? So everybody knows that he gave nothing to his brother. So here your sentence will begin with subject he. Okay, here since it is simple past tense, did is showing that the sentence is given in the simple past tense. So he gave, did will be removed and give will become gave. Okay, I think you know that. He gave nothing. So nothing will come over here at the place of object. Remember that we will see in active passive also. Here also you can just keep that thing in mind, that nothing and everything will come at the place of object only. And object normally is written after the verb. So here your verb is gave. So after that we wrote nothing. He gave nothing to his brother. Okay. So this was a positive question. We put nothing, so it became negative sentence, negative assertive sentence. Okay. Now again, if we take a negative sentence. Example. What does he not sacrifice for his safe marriage life? Okay, what does he not sacrifice for his safe marriage life? So here does not, negative sentence, so there we will have to use everything. So the sentence will begin with he sacrifices. Students, you see, purposely I am taking the sentences of did and do and does, because when you write such sentences, certain changes will take place. Here did will be gone, here does will be gone, not also will be removed. Okay, and there will be some changes in the verb. Here gave became gave, here sacrifice becomes sacrifices. Okay, when does is removed, the verb takes s, es or ies. Here it will take only s. So he sacrifices everything for his safe marriage life. Okay students, so I think this much is quite clear. Okay, I can take the examples from the other tenses also. What should he do? What should he do to win his favor? What should he do to win his favor? So he should do nothing to win his favor. So here again you see students, should is there, so I have kept should as it is. He should do nothing to win his favor. Okay, so like that students, you see what sentence is given in any tense, the same tense should be maintained, and only after the verb you are supposed to put nothing or everything, and your sentence will be ready. So here again you see what sentence is what sentence is an interrogative sentence, and when you convert it into assertive, only you are adding nothing and everything. In who sentence, you see, वी आर राइटिंग एवरीबडी और नोबडी इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द सेंटेंस बिकॉज द सेंटेंस ऑलवेज बिगिंस विद द सब्जेक्ट एंड इन हु क्वेश्चन सब्जेक्ट ओनली इज नॉट गिवन इन वॉट क्वेश्चन ऑब्जेक्ट इज नॉट गिवन सो यू आर राइटिंग वी आर राइटिंग नथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग एट द प्लेस ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट ओके along with that you just see that in simple present and past tense you are supposed to maintain these changes okay verb form changes give becomes gave and here sacrifice becomes sacrifices okay with practice you will just master this particular topic okay now there are again some more questions for what let's see how they are changed here I have sorry I have taught you only What positive question and what negative question? Now there are some other questions. They are of different types, but they are not done this way. Okay, few words you are supposed to add in the beginning of such sentences when you convert them into assertive. Okay, you must have heard students what I am talking about. I am talking about. What those sentences okay certain sentences certain questions begins with what though now in such sentences what are we supposed to do we have to begin the assertive sentence with it does not matter much though and then remaining sentence as it is so in place of what though you are supposed to add these words and then the remaining sentence you connect so your assertive is ready okay let's see one sentence as an example what though you failed in the first exam so again you see it is a question it is a positive question what though you failed in first exam so whenever you come across such words what though instantly when you convert them into assertive you are supposed to use these words it does not matter much it does not matter much though you failed now remaining sentence as it is okay though you failed in the first exam okay students I think it is clear let me give you one more example what though He feels jealousy for you. What though he feels jealousy for you? So it does not matter. Much though he feels. Jealousy for you. Okay, students. So here you see, whenever you come across these type of sentences, what though? Its assertive will begin with it does not matter much though, and then the remaining sentence you are supposed to connect with that. So that way it will be quite clear. Understood? So these are the students you see what questions. Okay, there are a few more questions. We will see. Now students we will see when question okay so students have you got any idea about the when question when question is positive how are we converting it into assertive when question is negative how are we converting it into assertive So I'll show you over here. So when question is positive. Okay, students. So here in its assertive, what do we use? We use never. It is so simple. And when question is negative, then we use always. These two words, students, you keep in mind. Okay, when question is positive, we use never in its assertive. And when question is negative, we use always in its assertive. Example, when did I hurt you? Okay, students, when did I hurt you? So its assertive would be what? I never hurt you. This is the assertive of that sentence. Here when question was positive, there is no word like no, not, never, aisa koi word hai hi nahi. And that's why when question is positive, when you convert it into assertive, you are supposed to add never. So I add. Understood? Then when do you study maths? Okay, second example. So its assertive would be you never study maths. Okay, students, so this way you see when positive question is there, then you are supposed to add never in that. Again, never will come in ever and never also. Okay, similar sentence. Suppose this sentence is given as an assertive sentence and you are asked to convert it into interrogative. Then what will happen? You can write when question also, and you can write simple yes no question also by using ever. Okay, by looking at the sentence, you can say that you never study maths. So study shows that the sentence is of simple present tense. So here you can also write, do you ever study maths? Okay, so students, here you see for this sentence there are two interrogative forms. One is with when, one is with ever. So with ever also you can write, with when also you can write. You never study maths. So when do you study maths? Or do you ever study maths? So ever ka never ho jata hai, or when ka bhi never ho jata hai, when sentence is positive. Okay, now students, we will see a few examples of when sentence when it is negative. Okay, I'm writing a few more examples for you. When didn't I help you in your troubles? Okay, so when didn't I help you in your troubles? Maine tumko tumhare troubles mein kab help nahi ki, means I always helped you. So here in place of never, we will write what? Always. I always helped you in your troubles. Okay, students. So here you see didn't is there, so it is a negative when question. And when negative when question is there, then we use always. So similarly, I have also used always over here. Okay, second sentence we will take. When don't you complete your homework? Okay, simple sentence. When don't you complete your homework? It means you always complete your homework. There is no question about not completing at all. Okay, so here it will be you always complete your homework. Okay, students, so here there are these two examples. You can also have many more examples of different tenses. Okay, so for example, when should I play this shot? So I should never play this shot. When shouldn't I play this shot? Means I always should play this shot. Okay, students. So like those, so many examples are there. Where when question is positive, then we will use never. When question is negative, we will use always. So I think in this video, these three things are quite clear. Who question, what question, and when question. Okay, in who question we saw that when who question is positive, its assertive begins with everybody or everyone. Sorry, nobody or no one. When who question is negative, its assertive begins with everybody or everyone. When what question is there, where what question negative, then we use everything after the verb. When what question is positive, we use nothing after the verb. When what question is having though word, what though? So there we will write, normally write, it does not matter much though, and then the remaining sentence. Then in when question we saw, when question positive, so in assertive we use never. When question is negative, in its assertive we write always. So I think these three are quite clear right now. And the earlier sentences, just yes no type sentences, we saw in the first video. So students, kindly keep this much in mind. Next time when we meet, we will again see a few more sentences which are still left. Okay, like those sentences also will be asked. Why sentences, where sentences, so in such type of sentences, what do we do? All those things, students, we will see in my next video. Till that time, study this much. Take care. God bless you. Have a nice day.